Hello and welcome to Jobs and Education. Do subscribe and share my videos. This is your Mahesh Dole. IC engines means internal combustion engines. Very important topic for every mechanical engineering student as well as aspirants. First of all, what is heat engine? A device for producing motive power from heat. A heat engine is a system that converts heat or thermal energy to chemical energy, and finally it converts to the mechanical energy. This is a heat engine. What are the types of heat engines? There are two types are there. One is internal combustion engine, another is external combustion engine. What is external combustion engine? In an external combustion engine, the fuel burns outside and away from the main bit of the engine. Examples are steam engine, steam turbine, and closed cycle gas turbine. What is internal combustion engine? In an internal combustion engine, the fuel burns inside the cylinder. The examples are gasoline engine, diesel engine, open cycle gas turbine. So classification of internal combustion engines, IC engines. So by number of strokes, it is 2-stroke and 4-stroke. By type of ignition, it is compression ignition or CI engine, or spark ignition or SI engine. Based on applications, automotive applications like car, bus and trucks, light aircraft, marine applications like outboard and inboard and ship, agriculture applications, tractors and pumps, earth moving applications, dumpers, tippers and mining equipment. Based on engine design, reciprocating single cylinder and multi cylinder, rotary type is single rotor and multi rotor. So these are the classification of internal combustion engines. Constructional details of an IC engine means what are the parts of IC engine. The main important parts are cylinder, cylinder head, cylinder block, crankshaft, connecting rod, camshafts, valves, spark plug, piston, crank pin, gudgeon pin, camshaft and push rods, and rocker arms. Observe these two figures. We can see here it is a spark plug. This is a spark plug. Exhaust valve, inlet valve, those are valves. Cylinder head, it is at the top of the cylinder. This is cylinder. Piston rings are there. Piston is there. Connecting rod, crank case and crank shaft. From TDC, top dead center to bottom dead center, that is called as stroke. So this is clearance volume. This is cylinder valve. SI engine means spark ignition engine. So this is nothing but petrol engine. So 4 strokes are there: suction, compression, expansion and exhaust. Look at this animation, we can understand clearly what is happening, how the suction stroke is happening, compression and expansion and exhaust strokes are happening. Working of SI engine. A spark ignition engine is an internal combustion engine, generally a petrol engine, where the combustion process of the air fuel mixture is ignited by a spark from a spark plug. A 4-stroke spark ignition engine is an Otto cycle engine. Each stroke consists of 180 degree rotation of crankshaft. Hence, 4-stroke cycle is completed through 720 degree of crank rotation. Thus, for one complete cycle, there is only one power stroke while the crankshaft turns by 2 revolutions. First stroke is suction stroke. This is also called as intake or induction. This stroke of the piston begins at the top dead center and ends at the BDC, bottom dead center. This is top dead center. This is bottom dead center. So piston moves from TDC to BDC. So in the stroke, the intake valve must be open while the piston pulls air fuel mixture into the cylinder by the producing vacuum pressure into the cylinder through its downward motion. When this inlet valve opens, air fuel mixture comes inside. This piston moves downwards. Second stroke is compression. So understand this figure. So the piston moves from this BDC to TDC. Look at this. The piston is at BDC. So from BDC to TDC, it goes upwards. When it is going upwards, whatever the air fuel mixture is there inside this cylinder, that will become compressed. So that is happening in the compression stroke. So let's see. This stroke begins at BDC or just at end of the suction stroke and ends at TDC. So BDC to TDC. In this stroke, the piston compresses the air fuel mixture in the preparation for ignition during the power stroke. So both the intake and exhaust valves are closed during this stage. Both the inlet and exhaust valves are closed in the compression stroke. Third stroke is expansion stroke or power stroke, also known as power or ignition. This is the start of the second revolution of the four stroke cycle. At this point, the crankshaft has completed a full 360 degree revolution, while the piston is a TDC, the end of the compression stroke. Means at the end of this compression stroke, piston is at the top position. At this end of the compression stroke, the compressed air fuel mixture is ignited by a spark plug. Here a spark plug will be there that will ignite the compressed air fuel mixture, that forcefully returning the piston to the BDC. Because of this spark plug ignition, the compressed air fuel mixture will burns. Because of that combustion, the piston moves downwards like this. So forcefully it returns to the BDC. This stroke produces mechanical work from the engine to turn the crankshaft. Fourth stroke is exhaust stroke, so also known as outlet. During the exhaust stroke, the piston once again returns from BDC to TDC, means bottom dead center to top dead center, so from here to here. So while the exhaust valve is open, this is the exhaust valve opens, so this action expels the spent air fuel mixture through the exhaust valve. What are the burnt gases are there inside this cylinder? So when the piston comes upwards, so this exhaust valve opens, so what are the exhausted burnt gases are there that will go out of this exhaust valve. What is CI engine? This is nothing but compression ignition. So diesel engine works by compressing only the air. This increases the air temperature inside this cylinder to such a high degree that atomized diesel fuel injected into the combustion chamber ignites spontaneously. In this diesel engine, so we don't use a spark plug, here we'll use a fuel injector. So at the end of the compression stroke, the fuel injector will inject the diesel. This is only the difference between SI engine and CI engine. In SI engine, we use spark plugs here. In CI engine, we'll use fuel injector. So what is the suction stroke in a CI engine? So as same as a petrol engine, in diesel engine also the suction stroke is same. So inlet valve opens, the charge will come inside, the piston moves downwards from top dead center to bottom dead center. But whatever the charge is coming inside, that charge is nothing but only air. But in the case of petrol engine, air plus fuel mixture. In diesel engines or CI engines, only air will come inside through this inlet valve in the first stroke, that is suction stroke. So in the compression stroke, same as it is, this piston moves from BDC to TDC. So when it is moving from BDC to TDC, whatever the air is came inside this cylinder in the suction stroke, that will become compressed. So the piston rises up the closed cylinder, the compressing the air and making it very hot. So both intake and exhaust valves are closed during this stage. Third one is expansion or power stroke. At the end of the compression stroke, means the piston came to this top dead center. So here already air is compressed to very high pressure. At that time, the fuel injector will inject the diesel like a spray. When that diesel sprayed on that high compressed air, what happens? Automatically it burns. The burning fuel expands rapidly and the pressure rises, and therefore the piston is pushed down and the crankshaft is turned. So when the compressed air is mixed with the sprayed diesel, so with that automatically it burns, so it start combustion. Because of that, the piston comes downwards. The final stroke is exhaust stroke. The piston moves from BDC to TDC. When the piston moves from BDC to TDC, whatever the burnt gases are remained here, they'll go out of this exhaust valve. So when it reaches the top again, the exhaust valve closes, the inlet valve opens, and the sequence starts again. So whenever the exhaust gas is thrown outside, this process is called as scavenging. So automatically inlet valve opens, the piston moves downwards, so the charge comes inside. So this will happen, this cycle repeats. So what is two stroke engine working? Just now we seen four stroke working of CI engine and SI engine. What is the difference between two stroke and four stroke engines? In four stroke engines we seen inlet valve and exhaust valve, but in the two stroke engine we can see ports. So three ports are there: inlet port, transfer port and exhaust port. So this is inlet port, this is exhaust port, and this is transfer port. So here the simple working is that the charge will come from this inlet port and it will rotate through this crank. and it will pass through this transfer port and it enters to the cylinder from here. So it compresses here and burns here, and it will go after burning, whatever the burning gases are there, that will come out of this exhaust port. This is the working of two stroke engine. If it is petrol engine, we'll use a spark plug. If it is diesel engine, we'll use fuel injector. So two stroke engine working, let's look at the figure. So inlet port, and this is transfer port, and this is exhaust port. It is a type of internal combustion engine which completes a power cycle with two strokes of the piston during only one crankshaft revolution. In the four stroke engine, two revolutions of crankshaft, but in two stroke engine only one revolution of crank. In a two stroke engine, the end of the combustion stroke and the beginning of the compression stroke happens simultaneously. Combustion stroke and compression stroke happens at a time. Look at this. Whenever the charge is compressed here, automatically the inlet port opens and this charge will come inside, and it will compresses in this crank case. So next it will pass through this transfer port to this engine cylinder. The very important thing is that comparison of two stroke and four stroke engines. Let's see two stroke, and this is four stroke. In two stroke, so a two stroke engine has two strokes, four stroke engine has four strokes. It has three ports, inlet port, outlet port and transfer ports. But in four stroke engine, only two valves are there. They are inlet and outlet valves. One power stroke is there for every single revolution of crankshaft, wherein four stroke, one power stroke is there for two revolutions of crankshaft. Lighter flywheel is required in two stroke engines. Heavier flywheel is required in four stroke engines. It causes more pollution. Comparatively, four stroke produces less pollution, and in two stroke it required greater cooling and greater lubrication, and in four stroke less cooling and less lubrication required when we compare with the two stroke. Less volumetric and thermal efficiency in two stroke engine, but four stroke engine more volumetric and thermal efficiency is available. So applications of two stroke engines are scooters, motorcycles and moped ships, etc. Four stroke engine applications are cars, buses, trucks, tractors, etc. This is the comparison of SI engine and CI engine. It is nothing but differences of SI engine and CI engine. This is SI engine, this is CI engine. So SI engine works on auto cycle, CI engine works on diesel cycle. In SI engine, it is having less compression ratio. It is from 6 to 10 compression ratio. Whereas in CI engine, it is 12 to 22 compression ratio. Charge in the SI engine is air plus fuel, air fuel. And in CI engine, only air is as the charge. In CI engine, only air will suck into the cylinder. Initial cost is less for SI engine. Initial cost is more for CI engine. Pressure ranges from 6 bar to 12 bar and temperature ranges from 250 to 350 degrees centigrade in SI engine. CI engine pressure ranges are 35 bar to 40 bar and temperature ranges are 600 to 700 degrees centigrade. In SI engine, quality governing is required. In CI engine, we'll use mostly quantity governing. SI engine having carburetor and spark plugs. CI engine having fuel injection pumps and injectors. In SI engine, combustion takes place at a constant volume process. And in CI engine, combustion takes place at constant pressure. SI engine having low thermal efficiency. CI engines having high thermal efficiency. These are the differences between SI engine and CI engines. Thank you for watching this video. Do subscribe and share my videos. This is your Mahesh Dole.